The issue that we are holding this press conference is on the question of electoral bonds that the government has brought in through a surreptitious amendment in the finance bill in 2016. And through this, as we have argued, the entire transparency in political funding by the corporates is virtually been eliminated, and there is much greater opaqueness. Now, this is dangerous in the sense that any foreign company can also now donate to political parties, and nobody knows who is the one donating, which is the party receiving, and they have removed the earlier clauses and stipulations which had a ceiling on the amount a corporate can give to a political party. And that was 7% of the profits that were generated on the average in the last 3 years. Now that is gone, which means shell companies can be set up, money laundered, and given to the political parties through these electoral bonds. Already, without these electoral bonds coming into operation, in 2016-17, 89% of all corporate donations in the country to political parties, 89% went to the ruling BJP. Now this comes on the top of the fact that just 1% of the Indian population has cornered 73% of all additional wealth generated in 2017. Then see it with another fact, that during these last 3 years, more than 2 lakh crores of rupees worth of NPAs have been virtually written off by the government. The government refuses to give a loan waiver to the farmers who are committing suicides. But to the corporates, more than 2 lakh crores of rupees of NPAs have been written off. Government claims that this is not written off. I mean, they are in some other category in the records of the banks. But these are categories that can never be recovered. So put together, this is nothing but a perfection of the process of crony capitalism, whereby corporates gain through such methods, and you have created a situation where shell companies can be established by anybody, and through them you route your money to go to the political parties, and thus make black money legally into white money through such donations. So all this talk of eliminating corruption, eliminating black money, is all a big hoax if this scheme is put in operation. The Supreme Court has issued notices to both the central government and the Election Commission. The Election Commission is earlier on record objecting to this particular method, and they have asked the central government to reconsider, and they have written to the government. Now what the new Election Commission will do, we do not know. But this notice has been served, so they'll also have to respond. And this is also to be seen by another surreptitious move that the government has made in this year's finance bill. If you remember, in the 2016 finance bill, they smuggled in a provision of a retrospective amendment to the Foreign Contributions Regulatory Act, that is the FCRA, whereby they legalized retrospectively the donations made by foreign companies to political parties. Now, on that occasion, when I was in the Rajya Sabha, we had moved 5 amendments to that finance bill, but since that was a money bill, the provision in the constitution is that the Rajya Sabha's amendments will be sent back to the Lok Sabha for consideration once, and with their majority in the Lok Sabha, what I've described as the tyranny of democracy, with their majority in the Lok Sabha, they just bypassed these amendments and granted that retrospective effect benefit. Now, that retrospective effect benefit was to start from 2010. That created a problem, and we have circulated a chart that shows you how much of donations were received by the two principal parties in our country, that is the Congress and the BJP. And of late, since the government has come, this government has come more to the BJP. But these are not covered by the retrospective act because it was before 2010. So now, in this finance bill, they have brought in a new, smuggled in a new clause, whereby this retrospective change will now come into effect, if the finance bill is adopted, will now come into effect from 1976. That is from the day the FCRA was actually legislated. The day the FCRA legislation came into operation, from that day, now retrospectively, they are permitting donations by foreign companies to political parties. Now, this again is a very, very dangerous move, whereby foreign companies, who owns them, who controls them, through what method are they raising their resources, how they are being given to Indian political parties, and if they are being given in such a big quantum to the ruling party, it is very clear that these donations are a form of investment by these corporates for trade-offs and for deals. This is nothing but crony capitalism of the highest order, as I've said earlier. So we think that this has to be rejected, number one. That is our plea before the Supreme Court. And we've argued that it is ultra vires of the Constitution. It actually violates the right to information. It violates the sections of the Constitution that we have also pointed out, that is Article 19(1)(a) and also of Article 14 of the Constitution. And therefore, we have also challenged the fact that this sort of a bill cannot be smuggled in as a money bill under Article 110 of the Indian Constitution. So this has to be repealed. That is our appeal before the Supreme Court. But in this context, I would like to say that given this manner in which this entire crony capitalism is operating and the opaqueness that has been created in political funding, the time has come for the country and for our democracy to seriously think of very deep electoral reforms in the country. CPIM has always maintained that the first step to ending political corruption is to ban donations by corporates to political parties. This is the supply side of corruption. You only talk of the demand side of corruption, but the supply side of corruption is the political, donations being made by the corporates. And unless this is plugged, political corruption cannot be ended. Instead of doing that, you're legalizing political corruption. Electoral bonds are nothing but the legalization of political corruption. And therefore, deep, far-reaching electoral reforms is necessary, which should include this ban on corporate funding. Instead, our position is that corporates must contribute to the functioning of Indian democracy. And therefore, like the social responsibility, corporate social responsibility, let there be a law which will define a percentage of the profits that will be given for strengthening democracy. And let this fund be the corpus which can form a system of state funding of elections. which exists in many Western democracies. And this process of state funding of political parties for electoral purposes, this will be a much more transparent method where people will know that political parties in accordance with the strength of what they have received of popular support in the earlier election. They will be, I mean, this fund can be dispersed, we can work out the mechanisms for that. And along with this, we would suggest that electoral reforms must also consider the introduction of a partial proportional representation in our country. Otherwise, we have this anomaly of central governments forming governments with less than a majority of the support of the people who have voted. This government is today in office with 31% of the popular vote. 69% of the Indian people voted against them. This anomaly can only be solved if you have a partial proportional representation in the country. And that is a demand which the BJP used to support the CPIM when they were in the opposition. But now, I mean, of course, they see the advantages of not supporting this thing. But for the health of our democracy, I think this is required. And therefore, as the corollaries to the petition, I think a larger agenda of deep-rooted electoral reforms to fine-tune Indian democracy is required. So we've circulated to you also the petition and the list of companies which have donated to the major political parties before 2010, foreign companies, which will now be legalized instead of actually proceeding on them according to law, will now be legalized through this amendment to the FCRA retrospectively.